Good morning, students. Let us start the new chapter named haloalkanes and haloarenes. Haloalkanes are the alkyl derivatives or the halides of alkanes, whereas haloarenes are the halides of aromatic compounds. Example, ethyl chloride. In this case, chlorobenzene. Now, why do we study this chapter? We study this chapter because we know that organic compounds consists of many functional groups also, not only the hydrocarbons, but the hydrocarbons containing the functional groups also. Now, it is difficult to add any functional group in any alkane. Like if I take C2H5 or C2H6, and if I want to convert this into C2H5OH, then it is very difficult because the strength of the bond between the carbon and the hydrogen is strong. They have strong sigma bond. But if we take C2H5Cl, it will be very easy to convert this into alcohol by treating it with aqueous KOH. KCl will come out and OH will take its place. This is because there is no polarity between carbon and hydrogen. No polarity is there. But in case of ethyl chloride, which can be also written as CH3, CH, H, Cl, there is polarity in the bond. As a result, in presence of water, which is a polar solvent, this bond can be easily broken, and a stronger anion can replace the weaker anion. And now, assuming that you remember the concepts of organic chemistry of class 11, I would say this as strong nucleophile, and this is weak nucleophile. So what is nucleophile here? Nucleophiles are positive charge loving species. Positive charge loving species. So alkyl halides, they provide nucleophilic site due to the polarity between carbon and halide. Between the carbon and the halide, due to polarity, this acts as a nucleophilic center or nucleophilic site, whereas an OH minus ion acts as a strong nucleophile. Nucleophile means positive charge loving species. So OH minus ion takes its place and Cl acts as a leaving group. This leaving group is further taken out by Ca plus and it forms KCl. In organic chemistry, we don't talk about the byproduct. This is byproduct. We don't talk about the byproduct. We only talk about the major product. CH3, CH2, OH is formed. On the contrary, since we have used here water, it was very easy to be done. Now, if I compare two molecules, say I may take C6H13Cl, or this can be also written as CH2 or CH3CH2, CH2, 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 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and Cl. Or we can, in short, we can write 1, 2, 3, 4 as CH3, CH2 whole 4, CH2, Cl. Or for our clarity, we can also write this as CH, H, lights. This is one molecule. This is chlorohexane. Now I am taking another molecule. Here also lone pairs are there. There is polarity here. Now this can be converted into its alcohol very easily. Just treat it with aqueous KOH. And substitution reaction will take place. It will form CH3, CH2, whole 4, CH2. OH and KCl will come out. But in this case, if you give aqueous KOH, no reaction will occur. Then what is the nature of bond between the carbon and the halide in case of arenes? In case of arenes, the bond between the carbon and the halide is stronger. Okay? It has a stronger covalent bond. But why? This is because of resonance effect. In class 11th, you might have studied about electron displacement in covalent bond. According to that, this lone pair goes here and it comes out. And its resonating structure, one of its resonating structure is also like this. Chlorine plus so it has a double bond character. Double bond character. Due to which this bond does not break easily. Hence, to convert chlorobenzene to phenol, we have to give drastic condition. We have to fuse it, means melt it together with NaOH. If you fuse with NaOH, it is also called as dose process. Then OH will come. So it requires drastic condition. Lots of heat is required. Because this bond is strong bond. Because it has a double bond character. B, B, C. It has a double bond character. Okay. So this was the difference between the nature of carbon and halide in haloalkane and haloarene. Now we'll see some process of preparing haloalkanes and haloarene. Before that, let me again summarize this. Nature of carbon halide bond in haloalkanes. What is the nature? Its nature is polar and weaker. What is the nature of carbon halide bond in haloarenes? Can make it in any ways possible. All these positions are equivalent. So what is the nature? First is less polar due to resonance. Less polar, also that the bond is resonating. Third, has double bond character. What is the effect of this double bond character? Effect of double bond character is that it can be converted into C2H5OH easily by treating it with aqueous KOH. But to convert this into phenol, you need to fuse it with NaOH, melt it with NaOH. It is called as dose process. Now we'll go to the next topic, that is preparation of haloalkanes and haloarenes. First, if you take C2H5, or if I write it in structural formula form, it will become more easy to understand. Treat it with PCl5 and heat. It will produce PCl3 and Cl2. This Cl2 will take out HCl and one chlorine will get added. So it will form CH3, CH2, Cl and plus HCl. And this is the major product. Second, take CH3, CH2OH. Treat it with SOCl2. It will form CH3, CH2, OH. Now let us see a few methods of preparing haloarenes. Say if you want to make chlorobenzene from benzene. So, yes, you can take chlorine, but only chlorine will not work. You have to treat this chlorine with FeCl3. This will produce FeCl4 minus and Cl plus. This Cl plus is nothing but electrophile. It contains lots of pi electron, so it is electron rich, and it is electrophile. Although it is not shown, but it is understood that each of these carbon also contains one hydrogen to complete its tetravalency. Look at it in this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, this electrophile, it comes and forms a pi complex at first. And then later replaces 1H plus and takes its place. Then what does this H plus do? This H plus reacts with the FeCl4 minus. This H plus reacts with FeCl4 minus to form FeCl3 and HCl. So in this way we can produce chlorobenzene. This was one way. Another way could be we can allow benzene to undergo photochemical chain reaction in presence of chlorine and sunlight. Now in 6 steps 6 HCls will come out one by one. In 6 steps 6 HCl will come out and it will form chlorine, 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 and chlorine, and 6 HCl. This is called as BHC or benzene hexachloride. BHC, benzene hexachloride. So what we have seen so far, we have seen that haloarenes or arenes, they undergo electrophilic reaction, whereas the haloalkanes and the alkanes, they undergo nucleophilic substitution. So before understanding any other reaction, let us try to differentiate between the nucleophilic reaction and electrophilic reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. We will again take CH3, C, H, H and Cl. In presence of aqueous KOH, that means K plus and OH minus, OH minus tries to come and attack on the chlorine from behind. Because it is also negative, it is also negative. So if it comes from this side, it will have repulsion. But if it comes from back side, it will be more preferred. As a result, it forms a 5-membered transition state. The carbon molecule should have 4 substituents around it because it is tetravalent, but due to this backward or backward attack, this is attacking species and this is substrate, a 5-membered transition state is produced like this: carbon, methyl group, this one, this hydrogen here, this hydrogen here. Now this chlorine bond, carbon chlorine bond, becomes weaker. This becomes weaker and the OH minus now attacks from behind. So it forms a five-membered transition state. This step is a slow step. And the slow step is a rate determining step. Slow step is rate determining step. So the order of this reaction is rate is depending upon the concentration of OH as well as the concentration of alkyl halide. It is depending upon the concentration of OH as well as it is depending upon the concentration of C2H5Cl, and hence its order is order of reaction is 1 plus 1 equal to 2. Order of reaction is 2. This type of reaction is called as substitution nucleophilic bimolecular reaction, SN2 reaction. Okay, so what S stands for? S stands for substitution, N stands for nucleophilic, and 2 stands for order 2 or bimolecular reaction. Now in this type of reaction, the product formed will always be inverted. Inverted in the sense, here the methyl group was in the left hand side. It was in the left hand side. But after the OH will attack, the molecule will flip like an umbrella. The molecule will flip like an umbrella. Like methyl group was this side. Now methyl group will go that side. So it will flip like an umbrella. Okay. So I will make this molecule a little smaller now, so that I can make the product too. So I am just going to make the same thing, not a different thing. Just to create space in the board. OH minus attacking carbon, hydrogen, methyl, hydrogen, leaving group, 5-membered transition state, now this becomes, this will flip that side, so it will become carbon, hydrogen, OH, H and CH3. So in this kind of reaction, what will happen is inversion of configuration will take place. Inversion of configuration will take place. Flipping of umbrella. Flipping of umbrella. What happens in thunderstorm? Flipping umbrella. Analogy. Apply flipping umbrella analogy. Inversion of configuration. Now whatever we have studied, let us summarize it once. Let us take the example of a molecule like CH3, CH3, CH3. chlorine. IUPAC name of this will be 1, 2, 3. 2-chloro-2-methyl, it will be like this. 1, 2, 3. 2-chloro-2-methyl-propane. Common name will be isobutyl chloride. Isobutyl chloride. This molecule, in this case, if you give KOH, then backside attack is not possible because of the bulky group. These all are bulky group. So first of all, this molecule will undergo sulfolysis and will form a carbocation like this. It will undergo sulfolysis and will form CH3 plus and plus Cl minus. Now this planar, it is sp2, it is planar. And OH minus ion now can attack from both sides, from above the plane and from below the plane. Now if it attacks from forward side, backward side, then inversion of configuration will take place. If it attacks from forward side, then retention of configuration will take place. So there are two possibilities. One is path A and there is path B. Path B. We'll see in both the ways what is formed. If attack takes place from path A, then it will form OH carbon CH3. If attack takes place from path B, then it will form COH CH3. So here chlorine was in this side, here OH is in this side. So it is retention of configuration. In this case, retention of configuration is taking place. Here retention of configuration is taking place and here inversion of configuration takes place. And in the slowest step, rate is proportional to only the carbocation C plus CH3 whole thrice. Okay, this is not involved. So it is unimolecular reaction. So this kind of reaction is called as substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction 1. Now let us try to summarize by differentiating between SN1 reaction and SN2 reaction. Non-bulky alkyl halides undergo SN2 reaction in which the rate depends upon both RCl or alkyl halide as well as OH-. But in this case, bulky alkyl halides undergo SN1 reaction. Here rate depends upon concentration of only the carbocation. Here, inversion of configuration takes place. Here, 50% inversion plus 50% retention of configuration takes place. Here optically pure compound is obtained. And here racemic mixture is obtained. So this was about the nucleophilic substitution reaction of alkyl halides. So alkyl halides, they majorly undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction, but it is not that alkyl halides will always undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. If they have any pi bond between the carbon atoms, they may also undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, but mostly they undergo SN1 or SN2 types of reaction. In SN1 and SN2 type of reaction, this is explained also in the chapter chemical kinetics. Okay, and it is again appearing here. Now we'll see how substitution takes place in aryl halides and in arenes. Electrophilic substitution reaction in arenes and halo arenes. if you want to convert this into chlorobenzene, then it is electron rich site. So to add chlorine here, this is an electronegative molecule or electronegative element. So how can we take out the positive part of it? An electrophile should always be a positive charge, negative charge loving species. Electrophile. Are electron loving species. So obviously they should be electron deficient or they should be cation. So how can we make a cation of chlorine? We can make a cation of chlorine by taking chlorine and treating it with FeCl3. This will form FeCl4 minus and Cl plus, yes, chloronium ion. Chloronium ion. Now what happens after the chloronium ion is produced? By treating Cl2 in presence of FeCl3. First of all, a pi complex is formed. Then the H, one of the hydrogen is replaced. And then sigma bond is formed. Lots of adjuncting structures are also formed, which I will be showing shortly. Now this H plus reacts with the FeCl4 minus and forms FeCl3. If you are interested to how to show the formation of this sigma bond, then this can be seen here like this. This bond comes out and gives electron to Cl plus. As a result, here positive charge develops and here chlorine is attached. Hydrogen remains, not a problem. Now this will come here and will form, plus charge will come here. Now this will come here and will form now very easily. Electron will prefer to give electron to this and it will go out, so it will finally form plus H plus. So these all are the resonating structures. Okay, these are all resonating structures which we show like this, pi complex. And then after that, sigma complex takes place and H plus comes out. Okay, in simple step we'll show like this, but in real it happens in this way. All right, so we'll do more practice of it. This thing will reappear in the concept of Friedel-Crafts reaction, then nitration. In many cases this will appear. Okay, let us see a few ways in which you can generate electrophile. If you have to add alkyl group on this, then take CH3Cl and treat it with AlCl3. It will form CH3 plus and AlCl4 minus. It is nothing but electrophile. And this electrophile will now attack on this and will form methyl benzene. Commonly known as toluene. If you want to add a ketonic group on this, then take CH3COCl, treat it with AlCl3. So AlCl4 will come out. And it will form acyl carbocation. This carbocation will act as electrophile and will form similarly, you can also add nitro group . This produces NO2 plus. This acts as electrophile. This electrophile reacts with this and forms nitrobenzene. So RCl, it is alkyl halide, say, if you add it with a nucleophile, then it undergoes nucleophilic substitution. But in case of aryl halide or arenes, you have to give one E plus, that means electrophile. It forms pi complex, then undergoes resonance and later forms neutrophilic substituted product. Alright, so aryl halides or arenes, they undergo electrophilic substitution reaction. So this was the concept of the reactions and the properties of alkyl halides and aryl halides. Now we will see the reactions without going into the details of the mechanism, because we have dealt it just now. Okay, so now we will simply make notes of the reactions and the explanation of that. Now I have done already, these explanations will be applicable wherever these reactions will occur. We will be discussing a number of name reactions related to the alkyl halides and aryl halides concept, like Schwartz reaction, Finkelstein's reaction, Balski-Mann reaction, Woods reaction, Woods-Wittig reaction, Gutterman reaction, Sandmeyer reaction. Okay, so these all reactions will come up in this chapter. In my next class, I will come up with the important name reactions of this chapter, which will take you more deeper into this concept of alkyl halides and aryl halides. Thank you.